From its history of discovery to its composition on the ground and in the atmosphere to what it might mean to Earth in the very near future, join me as I show you some of the history and facts about Mars. Number 9. How we found Mars. If astronomy has taught us anything, it's that the earliest civilizations that were on Earth were incredibly advanced in not just looking at the stars above, but understanding what the various things in the night sky were and naming them to help them understand more. And that includes finding Mars and understanding what it was. Some of the early records of Mars's observation date back to the era of the ancient Egyptian astronomers in the 2nd millennium BCE. Chinese records about the motions of Mars appeared before the founding of the Zhou dynasty, 1045 BCE. Detailed observations of the position of Mars were made by Babylonian astronomers who developed arithmetic techniques to predict the future position of the planet. The ancient Greek philosophers and Hellenistic astronomers developed a geocentric model to explain the planet's motions. Measurements of Mars's angular diameter can be found in ancient Greek and Indian texts. In the 16th century, Nicholas Copernicus proposed a heliocentric model for the solar system in which the planets follow circular orbits around the Sun. This was revised by Johannes Kepler, yielding an elliptic orbit for Mars that more accurately fitted the observational data. So just in the finding of Mars, you had a handful of civilization not just finding Mars, but slowly learning more about it long before the modern age of astronomy ever came about, which just makes it all the more impressive that they were able to learn so much. In terms of the modern age, the first telescopic observation of Mars was by Galileo Galilei in 1610. Within a century, astronomers discovered distinct albedo features on the planet, including the dark patch Syrtis Major Planum and polar ice caps. They were able to determine the planet's rotation period and axial tilt. These observations were primarily made during the time intervals when the planet was located in the opposition to the Sun, at which points Mars made its closest approaches to the Earth. Better telescopes developed early in the 19th century allowed permanent Martian albedo features to be mapped in detail. The first crude map of Mars was published in 1840, followed by more refined maps from 1877 onward. When astronomers mistakenly thought they had detected the spectroscopic signature of water in the Martian atmosphere, the idea of life on Mars became popularized among the public. Percival Lowell believed he could see a network of artificial canals on Mars. These linear features later proved to be an optical illusion, and the atmosphere was found to be too thin to support an Earth-like environment, but we'll get to that later. Still, just in the discovery of Mars and its most basic elements cap across thousands of years of discovery and investigation, and to this day we're still learning a lot about Mars. Number 8. Orbits and rotations. If you somehow haven't heard, the world is trying to get humanity onto Mars so that colonies can start to be formed. But to truly help people adapt to that notion, certain variables need to be understood, like how the orbits of Mars works, and the seasons that the planet may or may not have. First and foremost, a year on Mars is almost double that on Earth. Earth is 365 days, and Mars is 687 days. This is due to the fact that Mars is much farther away from the Sun than Earth is, and thus has farther to go. Now on the flip side though, the rotation of Mars is just barely slower than Earth's, so instead of a 24-hour day, we actually have a 25-hour day more or less. The actual number is 24.62. That's not too bad of a twist, right? As for the seasons, that's a bit trickier, because on one hand it does have spring, summer, fall, and winter in the overarching sense. But they all pretty much last over 150 days, roughly, versus the 90-day average of Earth. Spring, if you can call it that, even goes as long as 7 months. Winter is the shortest with about 120 days. Plus, since Mars's orbit is elliptical and not circular, it has two additional seasons called aphelion and perihelion, meaning that it's got a new season when it's closest to the Sun, and one season when it's farthest away from the Sun. If humanity is going to last on Mars, we're going to need to adapt to the seasonal changes, especially in regards to how the temperatures on the planet can swing wildly from day to night, as well as season to season on the surface. It's not an impossible thing to overcome, but it's something we'd have to be ready for. Number 7. Water on Mars. Without a doubt, one of the most important discoveries on Mars is that there is indeed water on it. As noted in its history from the Earth side of things, there was a long time belief that Mars always had water, but this was later revealed to be an illusion. However, as time went on, there were signs that there was some kind of water on Mars in its past, and possibly in its present. The only problem was that it couldn't be liquid water due to the thin atmosphere above the planet, as well as the total lack of magnetosphere. However, that doesn't mean they failed to find it. In July of 2018, scientists reported the discovery of a subglacial lake on Mars, the first known stable body of water on the planet. It sits 1.5 kilometers or 0.9 miles below the surface at the base of the southern polar ice cap and is about 20 kilometers or 12 miles wide. The lake was discovered using the Mars' radar on board the Mars Express orbiter, and the profiles were collected between May of 2012 and December of 2015. The lake is centered at 193 degrees east by 81 degrees south, a flat area that does not exhibit any peculiar topographic characteristics. It is mostly surrounded by higher ground, except on its eastern side where there is a depression. Add to that the various polar caps and other ice entities on the planet, and suddenly Mars isn't just a place to fantasize living on. We can do it because we know that there is water there that we can use. Before we dive even deeper into Mars and the various facts surrounding it, be sure to like or dislike the video. That way we can continue improving our content for you, the viewer. Also, be sure to subscribe to the channel so that you don't miss any of our weekly videos. Number 6. Atmosphere. As noted, Mars has a very complicated history in regards to its atmosphere. Mars lost its magnetosphere 4 billion years ago, possibly because of numerous asteroid strikes, so the solar wind interacts directly with the Martian ionosphere, lowering the atmospheric density by stripping away atoms from the outer layer. Compared to Earth, the atmosphere of Mars is quite rarefied. The atmosphere of Mars consists of about 96% carbon dioxide, 1.93% argon, and 1.89% nitrogen, along with traces of oxygen and water. The atmosphere is quite dusty, containing particulates about 1.5 micrometer in diameter, which give the Martian sky a tawny color when seen from the surface. It may take on a pink hue due to iron oxide particles suspended in it. In short, this means that we can't just openly breathe the air on Mars, and going to the planet without a pressurized suit would be dangerous in all the ways that matter. As such, any colony that we try and build there will be one that has to be pressurized and have oxygen made and recycled so that we can breathe. Number 5. Soil. You might think it odd to wonder about the soil conditions on Mars, but in fact, they're some of the most important things that NASA scientists are trying to learn about. The Phoenix lander was sent to observe said soil, returned data showing Martian soil to be slightly alkaline and containing elements such as magnesium, sodium, potassium, and chlorine. These nutrients are found in soils on Earth, and they are necessary for growth of plants. Experiments performed by the lander show that the Martian soil has a basic pH of 7.7 and contains 0.6% of the salt perchlorate. This is a very high concentration and makes the Martian soil toxic, which is very bad considering we're wanting to try and use that soil to grow crops for the future colonies. The other problem with the soil that scientists have noticed is that it's incredibly clingy as well as sharp. This means that astronaut suits will have to be very strong to not get torn up by the dust, and advanced cleaning techniques or creative ways to get in and out of the suits will be needed to ensure that the dust doesn't find a way inside the colony itself. As this dust would not just damage the ships and colonies, but if breathed in, could be very detrimental to the colonists themselves. As if that wasn't enough, there is speculation that there are billions of dollars worth of materials on Mars just waiting to be mined. Places like NASA and SpaceX are considering how to mine for those materials to help fund future missions to the Red Planet. Number 4. Pop culture. To say that Mars is part of pop culture on the planet Earth is an understatement in all the ways that matter. From basic references to being an integral part of shows and movies, Mars has been around. In the late 1800s, when people first observed the canal-like features on Mars' surface, many speculated that an intelligent alien species resided there. This led to numerous stories about Martians, some of whom invade Earth, like in the 1938 radio drama The War of the Worlds. According to an enduring urban legend, many listeners believed the story to be real news coverage of an invasion, causing widespread panic. Which is ironic because if they listened to the end of the program, the narrator clearly stated that it was just a story. Countless stories since have taken place on Mars or explored the possibilities of its Martian inhabitants. Movies like Total Recall, 1990 and 2012, take us to a terraformed Mars and a struggling colony running out of air. Martian colony and Earth have a prickly relationship in the Expanse television series and novels. And in the 2014 novel and its 2015 movie adaptation, The Martian, botanist Mark Watney is stranded alone on the planet and struggles to survive until a rescue mission can retrieve him. And keeping in line with the mythology of the planet, the name Mars has been awarded to various characters in cartoons and anime, and even video games for their strength, size, and godlike appearances. Number 3. Moons. The moons get their names from the horses that pulled the chariot of the Greek god of war, Ares. In ancient Greek, Phobos means light and Deimos means fear. Phobos, the innermost and larger moon, is heavily cratered with deep grooves on its surface. It is slowly moving towards Mars and will crash into the planet or break apart in about 50 million years. Deimos is about half as big as Phobos and orbits 2.5 times farther away from Mars. Oddly shaped Deimos is covered in loose dirt that often fills the craters on its surface, making it appear smoother than Phobos. The moons of Mars are another that are being studied very carefully. For while a full-blown colony may not be in the cards for these moons, a way station of sorts is possible, and certain theories about the future of space travel have pondered how these moons could help launch us into the back half of the solar system. Number 2. Terraforming. Given all the hardships that are on Mars, from the atmosphere to the soil to the seasons and more, it might seem that this is too big a risk to try and colonize it. And to an extent, you would be right. Even if everything goes right, it'll take years to set up a true colony on Mars. And to be honest, it probably wouldn't be the easiest living place for a long time. However, there are ideas and notions to try and warp Mars into a more sustainable habitat for us. Simply put, people are wondering whether we can terraform Mars into something more like Earth. Now obviously, this would be a grand endeavor, but it's not as much a sci-fi theory as you might expect. Some have put forth ideas of not terraforming the whole planet, but rather a section of the planet. Think of it like a country-sized safe zone where we could build the colonies in peace. Again, it's not that far-fetched. There are technologies out there that theoretically make this happen, including sending nanobots to the skies to help make an atmosphere of our own. Other theories could rework the ground itself into trying to make it something we can grow plants into. Right now it's all theory, but theory is the first step towards making something work. Number 1. Life on Mars. There are some in the world today who truly believe that Mars is where humanity will take its next grand step. If that is the case, it'll be the most significant thing humanity has done since landing on the moon. Plans from groups like NASA, SpaceX, and the ESA, and more, have their various plans to get to Mars and beyond. But will they happen? It's hard to say. And of course, even if they do land on the surface of Mars, will a colony really be that easy to set up? These are the questions we will have until we start taking steps towards human expansion in the universe. Thanks for watching, everyone. What did you think of these history lessons and facts about Mars? Which of these did you find most interesting? How long do you think it'll be until we get to Mars? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.